Robert Pattinson is one of the greatest actors of our generation. Period. I don't care what you think about his Twilight days. This man deserves recognition. And I say that because after seeing The Lighthouse, I thought about something. There's so many great actors in the world right now. Some do better than others. Some are good, but don't stand out. But some reach this certain level of acting that other actors just dream of achieving. And I think he's one of those actors. I would put his performance in here up there with Daniel Day-Lewis and There Will Be Blood. After watching what he does here, it makes me wish that any person in the world who thinks that he's not good enough to play Batman would be forced to watch this movie 100 times so their eyes can be open and they'll shut the hell up. To be honest, now that I've seen this, I don't think those Batman fans even deserve to have Robert Pattinson. The Lighthouse also stars Willem Dafoe. They're both lighthouse keepers in the 1800s, living on this little island for 4 weeks until some boat comes to pick them up. And over the course of those 4 weeks, they start to lose their minds. This is a story of isolation and paranoia. Things don't feel right from the start. Willem Dafoe keeps acting really sketchy, and Robert Pattinson just wants to make his money and get the hell out of here. This is a weird ass movie. Very, very weird and confusing and crazy. It's goofy. It's odd. I don't know how many adjectives I can use to describe how unusual this movie is, but I loved every minute of it. The camera work is hypnotizing. I started to get lost in this world just by the cinematography alone. I can't think of another time that that's happened to me where I felt the way I felt while watching this. There was so much style going on behind the lens that the more I watched it, the more I just wanted to leave the theater, pick up a camera, and go make a movie. My favorite decision they made as a whole was them shooting this film on a 1:19:1 aspect ratio, which is crazy because I have a short horror film script that I plan on getting filmed by the end of this year, and that's gonna be filmed with the same aspect ratio. So now that I've seen this, I'm even more motivated to go get it done now. But yeah, because of them doing that, it draws you in. It gives you almost some sort of claustrophobic feel. It gives your eyes no choice but to focus in on these two characters living in a small space together. The sound design is amazing. You always hear the strong wind from the ocean blowing in the background. The sound of the waves transports your mind away to this island. There's also these creepy sirens that keep going off in the background from the lighthouse that really does a good job at setting the tone for how uncomfortable Pattinson feels. Willem Dafoe gives one of his best and most ridiculous performances of his career. He has many lines of dialogue that go on for a while without the camera cutting away, and he's just going on and on about something. And the more he talks, the more impressed I was, because I was thinking, how in the hell can he memorize all of these lines? It's one thing for an actor to remember a long line of dialogue as a regular character in a regular movie, but this is the furthest thing from a regular character in a regular movie. This is not regular dialogue. He talks with a strong New England sailor accent, and there were moments when you could tell that Robert Pattinson was speechless just by standing in front of him. There's also a lot left open in the end for the viewer to wonder about. I can already tell this is going to be one of those movies where when the movie ends, at least one person in the audience is going to say out loud, "Well, that was stupid." Or if you go to see it in a theater in the South, like I did, you might hear someone say, "Shit, that was stupid as hell. I want my goddamn money back." But this is the type of ambiguity I like. I want to know everything, of course, but I'm okay with not knowing everything. This is one of those times where as soon as you get home, you're going to want to jump on Google and search up what the ending meant. You can tell that obviously everything in here has a meaning. Every shot, every scene, every bird, every scary image. Yes, there are a few horror elements, but it's not a horror movie, I don't think. I mean, I really don't know what category to put it in. Mystery slash horror, maybe? It's like if Wes Anderson ever wanted to make a scary movie, this is how I think he would do it. I think my biggest compliment would be is that there's no other movie I can really compare this to. As I mentioned, the way these characters talk is very captain of a ship-like, especially Willem Dafoe. And sometimes when they were having conversations, I honestly couldn't understand a damn thing they were saying. I would hear a certain word and then try to match it with another word and try to put two and two together just so I could comprehend what they were discussing. It might have been intentional now that I think about it, because it seems like the crazier they would get, the harder it would be to understand their language. The average filmgoer might find this boring because for a majority of it, it's just two characters standing around talking to each other. But even then, like I said earlier, the way the story is being told, just through camera angles and sound design alone, it's pretty hard to take your eyes off the screen. This is 100% one of my favorite films of the year. I can't wait to buy it when it comes out. I have to watch this multiple times. I have not stopped thinking about it since last night. If you're into artsy, very well-directed movies with great cinematography and amazing acting, then please give The Lighthouse a watch as soon as possible. That is the end of my review. Those are my thoughts. If you enjoyed hearing me spill the beans, please consider subscribing to my channel. Have a fantastic day. I'll catch you on the next video, which will be tomorrow.